Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss about sets. Okay, in mathematics, a set is a collection of distinct elements or numbers or object, okay, which is represent within the curly brackets. Okay, which is represent with the curly brackets. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, is a set of numbers. Okay, so there are three forms in which we can represent the sets. Okay, there are statement, suppose the statement, a set of even number less than 20, a set of prime number less than 7, these are, okay, 3, 5, this is a set of prime number less than statement, you have to write the set of even number less than 20. Okay, so next roster form, that is statement form. Next roster form, okay, which is like 2, 4, 6, 8, these are, okay, which is in the curly brackets. Okay, next you are getting set builder form. Set builder form, which is in the curly bracket, x such that x is equal twice n, where x belongs to n and 1 less than equal n less than equal 20. Okay, bracket closed. The sets are of different type. Yes, different. The sets are of different types, such as empty set, finite and infinite set, equal set, equivalent set, proper set, disjoint set, subset, etc. So we'll be learning in this chapter about some set. Okay, here we'll be discussing about statement. Okay, a meaningful sentence which can be asserted as true or false but not both is called a statement. For example, I'm writing here 5 plus 6, which is greater than 3. Yes? So you can say that this is a sentence which is true. Yes? You can say. Or if you am, I'm writing here pi, which is a rational number. Okay? Which is a rational number. Here you can say that this statement is not true. Okay, for the true statement you can denote a true T. Okay, for the true statement, and you can denote F for the false statement. Okay, the truth values, true or false of a statement, are denoted by the symbols T and F. Okay, so here we'll be learning the rules of finding the truth values of statement. For the first, I am making a table where you have a statement. P is denoted statement. Okay, and I am writing here negation of
T. Okay, the sign is called negation. Okay, so P is a statement which is true or false. Okay, we don't know, but here you can see that the statement I am writing here true and false. Suppose you have two statements, one is true and another is false. Okay, so always remember one thing: when you look negation in front of any true statement, then you can directly write that the statement is false. Okay, do you understood? If you see any that means a negation in front of any true statement, you can directly write that the statement is false. Okay, that means the negation of P is F, because the statement is true. So negation of statement is false. Okay, similarly, when you look negation in front of any false statement, then you can directly write that the statement is true. Okay, here you can see that the statement is false. Okay, so negation of false statement is true. Okay, just you need to write opposite term. Okay, always remember this thing. For the second chart, okay, I am making second table. Here you are getting again new thing. Here there are two terms, P and Q, and P disjunction Q. The statements are true, true, false, false. Okay, here true, false, true, false. Okay, this is the second table. So the sign, this is called disjunction. Okay, okay, we need to look for how many terms are there. You can see there are two terms, that is P and Q. Okay, for disjunction we can directly write two when both statements are true. You can see here both the statements is true. Yes, so for P disjunction Q, you can directly write that for the two statements, P disjunction Q is true. Okay, similarly, we can directly write false when both statements are false. Yes, you can see here both the statements is false. So you can write P disjunction Q also be false. Okay, here this first, second. Okay, second is quite different. I'm making here separately. You can see 2F, P disjunction Q and P and Q. The second is quite different. Suppose I am telling you a story. Okay, you can say this is a story. There are two boys are sitting together. Okay, from these two boys, one boy has bad habit. Okay, but another boy has good habit. Okay, suppose this is the bad habit boy, this one the good habit boy. Okay, so bad habit boy, good habit boy, trying to help bad habit boy to convert their bad habit into the good habit. Okay, that means at last we are getting result good. Yes, Z. Similarly, here also the T is the true statement, F is the false statement. Yes, so here T is trying to make F good. That means T, true. That means true statements trying to bring, trying to make false statement good. Okay, so at last we are getting the two statement. Okay, do you understood? So this is the story of the second. Okay, so you are getting the
P disjunction Q is true for the true and false statement. Okay, do you understood? That means bad boy cannot disturb good one easily. Good boy easily. Yes, just bad good boy help bad boy to convert into good. Yes. Okay. So next, the third one. Here you can see here. This is the third. Okay. So same. Here is a story. You can see here. True is trying to make false good. Yes. Same. Similarly, here also. Here you can see false and true. That means suppose here. For the third, you can see here Q is false and P is false, Q is true. P disjunction Q. Okay. Similarly, here also you can see that this is the true statement, this is the false statement. Okay. For the second third, you can see true statements trying to make false statement true. Okay. So the result we are getting. True. Yes, you can see that if both the terms are true, then P disjunction Q also true. Yes, if both the statement false, the result will be false. Yes, and you can see if there is a true, then false cannot disturb the true. Yes, true make the false good. Okay, always remember this thing. Okay, then you can easily solve the exercise solutions. Okay, next we'll be going to the third third. Okay, now we are moving to the third third. You can see I am making a table. P, this is called conjunction. Okay, Q. Sign is denoted for conjunction. Okay, so here just make true, false, yes, true, false. Okay, here the sign is called conjunction. Okay, we need to look for how many terms are here. Yes, you can see there are two terms. So here try to understand. Okay, look here, P and Q. Have you seen P and Q? And P conjunction Q. Okay, so you can see the both the statement is true for the first. Yes, both the statement is true for the first. Okay, so if you have true statement for the both term, you can write that P conjunction Q is also true. Okay, and look at the fourth one. You can see that both the statement is false for the third third. For the P conjunction Q, you can see both the term is, both the statement is false. Okay, so P conjunction Q is also false. Okay, but for the second and third, that is quite different. I'm making second true false. P conjunction Q, P Q. Okay, it is quite different. So here it is opposite to the second third. Okay, so you can see in the second third we are finding that if there is a true statement, the result will be true. Yes, but it is opposite to the second third.
you can see there is a false term. Yes, with the, you can see this is a false boy with the good boy, true boy. Okay, so false is trying to make good boy false.
Okay, so the P conjunction Q is
false.
Have you seen? It is opposite to the second third.
In the second third, we were getting that true is trying to make false true. Yes, but here false is trying to making true false. Okay, so you are getting false.
Okay, so let's move the third one. Similarly, here also
you can see false is trying to make true false. Yes, so the result is false.
Okay, so the third third, second and third is opposite to the second third. Okay, next move on to the fourth third. Okay, here we are getting fourth third. Okay, so here the symbol, this is called conditional. Conditional. Okay, so you can read P conditional Q. Okay, so you can see that similarly for the first, second, third, third, we can write for the true statement, you can directly write two. Okay, for the both two statement, you can directly write two. Okay, and we can so for the both statement, you can directly write two. Okay, that means P for the true statement, Q for the true statement, therefore P conditional Q is also true. Okay, okay, here for the fourth one, both the statement is false, you can see. Yes, okay, so for both the for the false statement, you can write, okay, P conditional Q is also false. Always remember these two. For the conditional, for P conditional Q, if both the statement true, you can write P conditional Q is also true. You can write for both the conditional false, you can write P conditional Q also true. I'm writing here false, sorry. Okay, so here the second and third is quite different. Okay. Here you can see, look, just try to understand this. Okay, I'm writing second one. Okay, so here look, this is the true statement, this is the false statement. Okay, so suppose you are driving a car. Okay, suppose you are driving a car, you have to go from the true to, that means from P to Q. Okay, so you are your initial point is T. Okay, so from here you start to move towards the F. Okay, at last you are getting F. Yes, if you start from here and you go towards the F, you are getting what? F. At last you are getting F. So your result is also F. Do you understood? This is the F. Next, for the third statement, for the third, that is F, that is T. Okay, here if you move towards the T from the F, at last you are getting T. Yes, so your P conditional T is T. Sorry, P conditional Q is true. Okay, okay, here you can say that P conditional, or you can say implication, you can say also. Okay, or implication. Okay, or implication.